we start to accept and when we start to tell very obviously and speak to the youth and tell them that they truly are our future, and we start telling them and making them believe that really without them there is nothing, I think the inspiration automatically gets to them. Because, you know, there is nothing so marvelous and so wonderful as being wanted and being loved and being told that, hey, you are going to take us ahead. And I think the inspiration also comes from the fact that today we're not talking about just youth of India, but I think youth of the world. And I think in the larger picture, we're all citizens of the world, and I think children know that now. And it's up to us, you know, to teach them well. First, I mean, it doesn't work like that. If you are a friend and you make time your friend, I think you tend to, every time you notice that time's going on ahead of you, you try to catch up. Or if you walk too fast and time's behind you, then you wait and let time catch up. So one way or the other, we need to walk hand in hand with time. And I think that's where one keeps oneself all the time getting reinvented. And I think, you know, I'm a compulsive optimist, and I never look at the bad side. Because I do believe that there's so much of misery in the world anyway. If you want to look for sad things, you find it all over the place. So, hey, why not look for the better things? And being a compulsive optimist, I would surely say that technology, of course, has helped forward music and get music to the whole world. And as I said, it shrunk the world. Music couldn't have done it without technology. And that's where I say it's so marvelous to be able to say to people, you know, kids today, right here, came and told me that, I mean, I have children loving my music anyway by the grace of God, but when they say that they saw me on the net, and they saw, I didn't even know how to go to the net, you know, I mean, it's true actually, I'm totally...